I know that some people in the US associate the Nordic model with some sort of socialism. Therefore, I would like to make one thing clear. Denmark is far from a socialist planned economy. Denmark is a market 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 economy. The Nordic model is an expanded welfare state which provides a high level of security for its citizens, but it is also a successful market economy with much freedom to pursue your dreams and live your life as you wish. But what does it mean to have a welfare state, you could ask? Well, for instance, we have universal health coverage. You don't pay to see your doctor or go to the hospital. We have a high degree of social security. You are entitled to benefits if you lose your job, if you get sick, if you are disabled. We have 1 year of maternity leave. We have subsidized early childhood education and care. And we ensure care for our elderly if they cannot manage on their own. We also have a strong and free educational system. Students in institutions for higher education and universities don't pay tuition. On the contrary, they receive educational grants for studying. So what is the catch, you could ask? And the most obvious one is, of course, the high taxes. The top income tax in Denmark is almost 60%. We have a 25% sales tax. And on cars, the excise duties is up to 180%. So in total, Danish taxes come to almost half of our national income compared to around 25% in the US. Quite a substantial difference, you could say. And we have to be honest about the problems related to the Nordic model. In a society with high taxes, we have to be very conscious about the incentives to work. In a society with a high level of social security, we have to pay special attention to the incentives among lower income groups to take a job. In a welfare state with a large public sector, we continuously have to make sure that we do not undermine the sense of personal responsibility and citizenship. And in a country where salaries are high and the distribution of wealth is high, we are challenged by foreign labor willing to work for salaries that are low in a Danish context. And my answer to all these different challenges is reforms, reforms, reforms. We have no choice but to reform our society in order to preserve the welfare state and the public support for it. We have to reform the public sector. The answer cannot always be send more money. Part of the answer is higher efficiency. We continuously have to find better ways to do things. For instance, ways to use digital technologies. And we have to bring about reforms which support a strong and effective public sector. We need more jobs in the private sector in order to afford our welfare system. And I want to improve our educations to improve the qualifications of the workforce. And I want to reduce taxes on labor, especially labor with lower incomes. Not, of course, to the level in the United States, that's unrealistic, but lower than in Denmark today. I want to improve our competitiveness, reduce taxes for business, remove red tape. Because without enough private sector jobs, the economy will lose its cohesion. For decades, we were used to the economy moving forward and upward. It was as if progress and growth was a kind of law of nature. But it wasn't.